To add an employee in Procare, go to the Employee Data Payroll module. You'll begin by clicking the Add Employee button right here. It'll bring up the New Person Information screen. At this point, you can type in the person's last name and their first name. And that really is all you need at this point to add the person. You could click Continue at this point if you'd like. I have more information for this particular person, so I'm going to go ahead and fill out the rest of the screen here, and then I'll be right back. And now we can see I've filled out the rest of the screen. I've pulled in a photo for Tamara from my photo gallery. I've added her home address, her home phone number, and her cell phone number over here. And I'm ready to continue at this point. And notice that I've got her social security number entered here as well. This is the only time you'll see the social security number is on this screen. All other screens will show it encrypted and only show the last four numbers. We'll click continue. If the person Tamara Johnson already existed in Procare somewhere else, perhaps as a parent or as a Procare user, and I'm confident that the person record I just added, which is this person record down here, is really the person record up at the top, and it's a complete person record, I would simply click Go Back and cancel adding the new person. This is just an example for you to show what the person reconciliation screen looks like if you've already got this person entered into Procare. In this case, I have just duplicated this for your information purposes, so I'm going to go ahead and go back and use the record that I entered. Once she's created as an employee, we have three other items we'd like to set up for her. First, we need to make sure she has a primary work area set, and that's in the Information and Relationship screen here. I need to set her primary school and her primary work area. In this case, she works in the toddler room normally, so I'll assign her primary work area as the toddler room. Save that information and exit that screen. The next thing I need to do is make sure that she has a work history status of currently employed. If you're using the Procare check-in and out station, she must have a status of currently employed on or before the date she's trying to use the check-in and out system. Otherwise, she won't be able to use it. So she should have a status there of currently employed. Go ahead and set that, and that is in the work history button. And then the last minimal item that you might need would be the pay rate. So here we want to assign at least an hourly pay code or a salary pay code, whatever her normal work position is. We'll say that she's a teacher, and in this case I'll go ahead and set up her rates $10.15 as overtime. And if I check the benefit box here, this is saying to Procare, use these rates for any benefits we might pay out to this employee, benefits such as vacation time or sick time or holiday time. And those are the minimal things you need to add an employee. From there, you would set up her withholdings if you were using Procare's payroll module. Click the withhold button, click the autofill button to fill in the federal and state income tax tables, and then add in whatever other withholdings you might have. This is referenced in the payroll module information, and set variables for the federal and state withholding allowances and married or single filing status. And that's how to add an employee to Procare.